Welcome children. Today we are starting with the topic differentiability. We have done a bit of it, the introductory part actually in class 11th also. So we will first quickly recall what is meant by it. Okay, what differentiation is. Now we saw that physically if we talk about its physical interpretation says that derivative denotes the rate of change of one quantity with respect to other. Okay. A very simple example of that is velocity. We know velocity can be defined as rate of change of displacement with respect to the change in time. So you can see displacement changes with time. As there is a change in time, there is change in displacement if we are talking about some moving object. Okay. So physical interpretation says derivative denotes the rate of change of one quantity with respect to other. But similar thing we noticed while defining its geometrical interpretation. If we have a line on which two points, neighboring points are given to you, say the coordinates of the neighboring points be x1, y1 and x2, y2. Then you can see while defining its slope, we saw that the slope of the line segment joining these two points will be y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. That means the difference in y coordinates divided by the difference in x coordinates. If we say our curve, or let us say the function is of the form y is equal to fx, if this is the equation of the curve, then if I replace this xy x1, then corresponding to it, the y coordinate will become fy1. And if we replace xy x2, then corresponding to it, the y coordinate will become fy2. So you can relate it to this. You will find the numerator is actually denoting the change in the dependent variable, okay, with respect to the change in the independent variable. So x is our independent variable, y is depending on it, okay. So change in y coordinates over change in x coordinates was defined as the slope of the line joining these two points. Now we have added a condition on it. If one of the x coordinate is very 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 close to the x coordinate of other point, let us say here if x1 is extremely close to x2, that means we are talking about the condition where this point is approaching the previous point, given one. If they are in the neighborhood of each other, very 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 close to each other, so that the difference x2 minus x1 is nearly zero, then corresponding to that, the difference in y2, the difference y2 minus y1 will also be almost equal to zero. So the condition under which the x coordinate, the difference in x coordinate is almost negligible, under that condition this ratio will be defining the derivative at that point. Okay, so keeping this in mind, we will go through the definition of a differentiable function. So a real function f is said to be differentiable at a point c in its domain if limit x tending to c fx minus fc over x minus c exists. So if this limit is existing, okay, for this ratio, this limit is existing, then only we can say that the function is differentiable. So that means what it implies, we need to check for any function, if we have to prove it is differentiable at a certain point, we need to check that the left hand derivative has to be equal to the right hand derivative. In case we are able to get this, then we can say that the function is differentiable at that particular point. So you will find that it is possible that the function is differentiable at a certain point, or it may not be differentiable. It depends upon whether we are able to define these limits or not. So how to write the left hand derivative? It will be limit x tending to c from the left. X needs to approach c from the left for the left hand derivative, and for the right hand derivative, it needs to approach c from the right side. Okay. Now, how to simplify it? You can see that as we have mentioned in the left hand derivative, that x, while applying the limit, x is approaching c from the left. So you can assume x to be a number which is slightly smaller than c. So if we assume x is say c minus h, then as x will approach c from the left, h will tend to 0. This kind of substitution we have already done while evaluating the limits. So I'm simply making that substitution. We are assigning a value to x because it says x is slightly smaller than c. So you can take a value in the left neighborhood of c. So limit h tending to 0, fc minus h over fc divided by this x we will replace by c minus h. So it will be c minus h minus c. So plus c and minus c gets cancelled out and we are left with minus h here. So this should be further equal to limit. Here x is approaching c from the right. So assign a value to x which is in the right neighborhood of x. Suppose x is c plus h. So as x will approach c from the right, h will tend to 0. So this is fc plus h minus fc over denominator will be c plus h minus c. So c and c gets eliminated and we are left with h. So if we need to check whether a function is differentiable or not, we need to check whether the left hand derivative and the right hand derivative at a certain point in the domain of the function can be defined or whether they can be shown equal to each other or not. Only if they are equal to each other, we can say the function is differentiable at that point.